non-believer and made him into a truth seer. Then I hit them to the game through his beat speakers. To the hood he was nothing more than a meat beater, until he dropped a mixtape full of heat seekers. Late nights in the quote-unquote lab, unemployed and broke but always found a way to get a dime bag. A couple loose to give a nigga a boost, and he's ready to let loose in his makeshift booth. Feeling so brand new, but he's long in the tooth. Punk rock as a youth, now he's spitting for goons, but they ignore him, cause they don't understand logic. They follow with blind faith, pariahs and false prophets. Promoting prostitution probably packs pain, but he learned from all the stupid mistakes his father made. Raising a brow or raising another child, since he had to teach himself what life was all about. And at the tender age of 14 years, he gave up the realism for a music career. Rancid in the morning, refused during the day. Vera Beach at night at the Vampire Cafe. The nerdy fat kid you see is good peoples. Darcy showed him love and Jim treated him equal. Joe Dyer in Philly made a fire from a spark, and he couldn't fight the tears when he heard about Mark. His Uncle Nick lost a blood brother, and he just left without a word, like a nigga wasn't concerned. Came back to the place that once defined him, looking for hope or somebody he could confide in. Fell in love with his best friend, the first girl to ever kiss him, cause his other friends dared them. But he was hooked, he read about it in books. He prepared his whole life for the moment he got a look. And for a second he finds his true place. He forgot about the way they used to clown him about his weight. Hair long, your boy was so cool, became a legendary ladies man right after high school. College didn't really prepare him for the world, but he learned about his race by chasing them white girls. He found a secret in the Puerto Ricans, and he would treat them like a queen, but didn't know how to keep them. Experimental drug binges on the daily. Used to be the smart kid, now he's Fox crazy. Under the influence, he was over life. Accidental overdoses in the middle of the night. Lucky for him, his boys pulled him out of it. Ride for the pride until he learned he had to swallow it. Forgot the lessons he learned to make statements. Pick up a couple new skills, including break-ins. Started a band, amassed a few fans. Understand, this is where he learned how he could just kill a man. He's the dopest, but he lacked focus, so he couldn't see his guardian angels were just vultures. Those he idolized thought he wasn't of the culture. Socially adept, emotional roller coasters. From one of the illest to just another nigga, he found omnipotence in the 380 trigger. It gave him power, confidence, respect, but his voice is a weapon to talk these niggas to death. I see him every couple days in the mirror, a constant reminder that the end is ever nearer. It's a little bit about my life. It's probably gonna be a couple more joints like this, man. I don't really like to let niggas know, but I feel that you need to know to understand. Gangsta like Claire, silent movies, baby.